millions of women around the world are on some kind of hormone replacement. Some women are taking estrogen, some women are taking progesterone, others are taking testosterone, some women may be on insulin because let's say they're diabetic, and others are on thyroid hormone replacement. And it seems that the majority of women are taking some kind of hormone replacement for some kind of hormone imbalance. Well, what do all of these hormone problems have in common? Well, the answer is gut health. Once again, we see just how important, just how vital gut health is to our overall health picture. Now, did you ever think that the health of your gut could influence the different hormones that your body makes? Did you ever think about the relationship between gut health and how people that suffer with gut health, how that affects hormone imbalances? Well, if I've piqued your interest, stay tuned, because this video is going to be an in-depth review of the connection between certain gut problems and how these gut problems affect hormones. Well, hey there, I'm Dr. Hagmeyer, and if you're struggling with the symptoms of a hormone imbalance or you're currently on some kind of hormone replacement, I think you're gonna find today's video just incredibly helpful. Today, I'm gonna unpack 5 of the most common female hormone problems that so many women really suffer from, and the problems in the gut that can either cause or exacerbate these problems. Here's the thing. How you think, how you feel, your happiness, your mood, your energy, your mental state, all of these things are closely tied into hormone health, but specifically the balance of your hormones. Believe it or not, many hormone problems can begin inside your gut, and this is because the gut microbiome, the trillions of bacteria that live in our digestive system, they play a huge role in regulating hormones. In fact, science has now coined this gut hormone connection the estrobolome. Now, when the gut microbiome is unhappy, it can cause problems with estrogen-related diseases, things like PCOS, endometriosis, fibroids, fertility, even metabolic diseases like cancer and thyroid disease and type 2 diabetes. Now, with that said, let's jump into how gut problems really affect estrogen. So healthy estrogen levels are important for women in every single stage of life. Estrogen regulates weight, fertility, cardiovascular health, mood, mental health. Estrogen is really what makes a woman a woman. And while so much emphasis over the last 50 years or so has centered around the production of estrogen in the ovaries, estrogen metabolism, meaning how estrogen is broken down in the gut and what it's being broken down into, is an exciting fork in the road when it comes to hormone health. Once estrogen enters the bloodstream, it then circulates through the body, goes to the uterus, it goes to the breasts, it goes to the brain, it goes to the thyroid, goes to various different organs until it reaches the liver, where it is then inactivated by phase 2 liver enzymes. Now, once inactivated in the liver, this estrogen is then sent to the intestines, where it's supposed to stay inactivated. So it can, of course, exit the body through the stool. That's what's supposed to happen. That's normal. That's healthy estrogen metabolism. Okay, so again, that's what's supposed to happen. Unfortunately, things don't always go as planned. When you have gut or intestinal dysbiosis, something very different happens. Unfriendly bacteria start increasing the production of an enzyme called beta-glucuronidase. Now, this is a really important enzyme. What beta-glucuronidase does is it breaks the tight bond between glucuronic acid and the estrogen in the intestines. And that can be a bad thing. Essentially, what happens and what this beta-glucuronidase does is it takes the estrogen that was meant to leave the body and essentially it reactivates that estrogen in the gut. Now, once reactivated, that estrogen re-enters your body and causes a whole host of problems that are related to excess estrogen. And this is a term you've probably heard. This is called estrogen dominance. Things like irregular periods, changes in mood, anxiety, depression, headaches, weight gain, bloating, fibroids, and so many other ailments begin to show up. Now, another problem some women suffer from is excess androgen levels. And we're hearing a lot about this in the news lately, right? This excess androgen production, like testosterone, this is associated with polycystic ovarian syndrome, or PCOS. Here again, gut problems contribute to PCOS. Now, PCOS, this is a hormonal disorder that causes some women to have cycles where they don't ovulate, meaning they won't be able to get pregnant. PCOS can cause women to have heavy menstrual cycles, heavy periods. It can cause multiple cysts to grow on the ovaries. It can cause weight gain. It can cause excess hair growth along the jawline, on the back. PCOS can cause acne, and obviously it can just destroy a woman's confidence and affect her emotionally. But what you might not know, again, is that PCOS and insulin resistance can be caused or exacerbated by gut dysbiosis. You see, the common thread when it comes to PCOS is chronic ongoing inflammation, elevated androgens like testosterone and DHEA, and you often see poor blood sugar control caused by insulin resistance. Now, across the board, we see these three problems in 90% of women with PCOS. Several recent studies in the European Journals of Endocrinology have actually found that women with PCOS often have elevated blood marker levels of something called zonulin. What's so special about zonulin? Well, zonulin is a protein that holds the gut lining, the gut cells together, and testing positive for this biomarker is an indicator that you have a leaky gut. Now, if you test positive for zonulin antibodies, that's the indicator that you have this leaky gut, you have this intestinal permeability. And here's what that means to you and why this is so very, very important. When you have chronic inflammation in the gastrointestinal tract, your gut becomes leaky. And this leakiness, this increased permeability, this allows large proteins called LPS toxins to enter the bloodstream. In the bloodstream, those toxins cause your immune system to go into a full swing of basically chronic immune activation. There's so much inflammation that takes place in the body. For women with PCOS who are trying to conceive, this overactive immune system and increased amounts of these inflammatory markers are also linked to recurrent miscarriages and infertility. So this leaky gut and this inflammation also inactivates the insulin receptors on your cells, which prevents glucose from getting into the cells to be used as fuel and as energy. And as a consequence of that, insulin resistance, glucose levels start to go up in your blood. And if your pancreas can't rebound, it can't, you know, carry out its function, that blood sugar now begins to lay the foundations for things like heart disease, fatty liver disease, metabolic syndrome, cancer, and type 2 diabetes. Not to mention, if your body can't use sugar, it gets stored as fat. So those high insulin levels also reduce something called sex hormone binding globulin. And if you're a woman with any kind of hormone problem, this is a biomarker that you need to have tested. You can ask your doctor to have this tested. And here's the reason why it's important. High fasting insulin allows more testosterone to exist throughout your body. Now again, that's not going to be good for a woman, right? A woman shouldn't have high levels of testosterone or these other androgens. A woman with too much free testosterone or other male hormones like DHEA can develop acne, facial hair, irritability, and again, many other PCOS symptoms. So this is how a leaky gut and intestinal dysbiosis can cause all the problems that we see being associated with PCOS. But here's the good news, and I see this in my own practice when I work with patients who have PCOS. When we improve their gut health, we improve the estrobilome, we eliminate this leaky gut, we also improve the PCOS and all the problems that PCOS causes. So if you're watching this and your doctor is really just putting you on metformin and testosterone blockers, I want you to understand that there's a lot more that can be done to help you. Now, let's talk about another problem that women who suffer with is endometriosis. Again, hormone imbalances. Here again, your gut might be your saving grace. Gut health is, and that estrobilome rather, influences conditions like endometriosis. Endometriosis, is an estrogen-dependent chronic inflammatory disease where tissue that's similar to the lining of your uterus implants on organs that are outside the uterus. The key takeaway here is that women who have endometriosis, A, they have too much estrogen, they have too much inflammation, and as a consequence of this, these women go on to further develop problems in their gut microbiome. They can get activation of mast cells. They can get stimulation of pain receptors, causing terrible pain in the uterus or in the abdomen or in the breast tissue. They can develop intestinal dysbiosis. And finally, they also can develop a leaky gut. So if you're a woman who has endometriosis, you should know that endometriosis has a significant overlap with irritable bowel syndrome. Okay. In fact, women with endometriosis have a 2x to 3x increased risk of having irritable bowel syndrome, 2 to 3-fold increase, that is. If you're wondering about ovarian, breast, and cervical cancers, if there's a link here to the gut microbiome, you should know that there actually is another strong link between gut intestinal dysbiosis and, again, these various types of cancer, especially cancer of the ovaries, breast, and uterus. Now, ovarian, breast, and cervical cancers, 80% of these cancers are what we call ER positive, estrogen positive, which means that these cancers use estrogen in order to grow and to multiply. Now, again, like I said earlier, the microbiome metabolizes excess estrogen to prevent it from recirculating in the blood and increasing the risk for these estrogen-sensitive cancers. Again, that was when we talked about beta-glucuronidase, right? This is one way the gut microbiome plays a very key role in ridding the body of this excess estrogen, as well as preventing the recirculation of toxins. But here again, that's not all a healthy gut microbiome is important for, right? Maintaining a healthy immune system, which is your body's first line of defense against cancer, right? What's the best way to prevent cancer? A strong immune system. Now, I've talked about an unhealthy gut and how it can lead to chronic inflammation, how it can increase mast cells and histamine, how it can cause a leaky gut, how it can cause intestinal dysbiosis. Well, if you're starting to see the bigger picture here, you're probably going to see that gut problems also present themselves as a significant risk factor for the development of cancer, right? We need to talk about the gut-thyroid connection next. Now, out of all the hormone-related problems that begin in the gut, the thyroid might be the one endocrine gland that's probably the most sensitive. Now, I've written numerous articles and have many videos on this channel where I talk about how important gut health is to the thyroid. And for people who suffer with autoimmune diseases like Graves' disease and like Hashimoto's disease. So I'm going to just give a quick overview on this thyroid-gut connection. But here's the deal. Poor gut health can suppress thyroid function and it can trigger Hashimoto's disease and Graves' disease and low thyroid function. And in turn can lead to an inflamed and leaky gut. Gut problems can affect the thyroid in several ways. Let's first start with how low stomach acid can contribute to this, right? Low stomach acid increases intestinal permeability. It increases inflammation, it increases intestinal dysbiosis, and it increases the likelihood of infections like H. pylori. And we know that upwards of 20 to 25% of our T4 to T3 conversion takes place by the bacteria in our gut. And so what that means is that the gut is an important area for the activation of our thyroid hormones. Now, a common symptom for women with low thyroid, again, GI-wise, is constipation. The problem with constipation is that this constipation can impair how your hormones are going to be cleared. If you can't clear these elevated estrogen levels, this estrogen will continue to go up and again affect your thyroid. Now, when you have too much estrogen, that excess estrogen will bind up all your thyroid hormones. And for many women who have those classic thyroid symptoms like fatigue and brain fog and weight gain and hair loss, they're often dismissed in their doctor's office because their doctor never tested their T3 levels. The doctor never tested their thyroid binding globulin levels. Very, very important. Now, you've probably heard the saying that 80% of the immune system resides in the gut. And this portion of the immune system that is so important is referred to as the GALT, or the gut-associated lymphoid tissue, okay? Now, the GALT stores immune system cells, such as our T and B lymphocytes, and it's these cells that are critical to our immune system. They carry out attacks, they produce antibodies against anything that they don't recognize as being part of our body, and they're a very important part of our immune system. They play an important role in autoimmunity. Well, when the gut barrier becomes permeable or leaky, large protein molecules escape into the bloodstream. The body once again mounts this immune system response and begins to attack them. Studies show that these attacks play a critical role in the development of diseases like Hashimoto's. Studies also show that T3 thyroid hormones help maintain that gut barrier in the stomach and in the intestines. And so if you have low T3, this can not only cause a leaky gut, but it can also lead to a fatty liver. Much of what controls whether your gut is healthy or in a state of unhealthy inflammation comes from our daily lifestyle habits. What you eat, what you don't eat, what you drink, what you don't drink, what supplements you take, if you exercise or don't exercise, all of these things, even the medications that you're taking right now or have in the past influence your microbiome. So how you treat your gut is eventually how it's going to treat you. So the key takeaway in this video is that a healthier gut means better hormone balance and a happier you. So that's going to wrap up today's video. I hope this video helps you understand not only some of the ways that your gut can contribute to hormone problems, but also some of the important areas of your health that should be further investigated should you have any of these hormone problems that I talked about in today's video. Now, if you like today's video, I want you to drop me a comment in the section below. And who knows, maybe I'll do a follow-up to this video. In the meantime, here's another video that I think is going to be very helpful to you and that I would recommend that you watch next.